What is up, everyone? So today I'm just gonna go ahead and show you how to do pretty much what you're seeing right here, which is just using a date picker and then selecting a date. And once you select that date, this information right here will update. Just like you can see, you know, let's pick April 6, 2021, and then put OK. And there it is. It's the day, the month, and the year. I picked that order. If you want to pick a different order, you will be able to do that. So all you got to do is just stick around and you'll learn how to do it. So here we are, and we're just starting from the last video that I made about how to format dates. And the first thing I'm going to do is create a new variable, and it's of type DateTime, and I'm just going to call it my date time. And you will see shortly why I just made this. So from the example you've already seen, you already know that the goal is to tap this button right here and then select a date, and the date will show up over here correctly formatted. This is the code from the previous lesson. Let's just leave it there for reference. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to use the show date picker function right here, which you also have access to. And then right here, if I tap enter like this, it's going to bring out the required parameters. Let me just organize this a little bit. There you go. This way it looks easier to understand. So basically the context, you already know it's the context right here. And for the initial date, we're going to go ahead and do datetime.now. And basically on the first and last date, you're basically setting the limit of the date picker, because you probably don't want your users to be able to go all the way back to, you know, the 1700s or the year 3000. That would just be a waste of resources and time. So instead, you just go ahead and set a first date limit and a last date limit. And the way you do it is using the date time. And as you can see right here, the year is a positional argument. And then you have these optional arguments as well if you want to specify the month or the day or the hour, etc. So basically what you do here, let's do 2010, for example. And then as the last date, we're going to do 2025. And this is basically the date picker. However, with date pickers, we're working with futures. So the first thing we're going to do here is turn this into an async function, because we want to save the data that you get from the date picker somewhere, right? And the way you do that is, let's just go ahead and use the variable that we created up there. I don't know if you still remember, right here, okay? And then we just need to await for this. And that's literally it. Once you have selected the date, that information will be stored in this variable right here. So if I save it right now, we can already access the date picker. But you know, if you pick it, nothing really happens because we haven't set that up yet. And we can do that right here. We can just comment this out and then do time equals datetime dot to string. And just like this, it will already work. However, before we put it to work, let's put this after the date picker has been awaited for, because otherwise the time variable would just be null. So let's just restart this. And now let's pick the date. It can be this one, I don't really care. And there it is. Very raw formatted, but there it is. Now let's put in a good format. So when you look at this, you can probably see what I'm going to go ahead and do, right? I'm going to delete this, and this is no longer relevant, so I'm also going to delete it. And we have the date format right here. It's still weird from that weird example that I showed you. Let me just fix that like this. And let's go ahead and take out the time because we're not selecting it. And right here, we're just going to do my date time. And I'm just going to restart this. And this time, once we pick the date, it will actually be properly formatted. Let's go ahead and pick this. And there you go. Exactly like it is here. The day, then the month, and then the year. And the thing is, right now, let me just go ahead and put in, I don't know, let's go to March 2022. If I tap this, it's right here. But if I tap this again, it takes us all the way back to August of 2021, which is the current date. And if you want to make sure that once the user taps this, it opens on the last day that they selected, then all you got to do is come over here and type in, you know, my date time. If it's equal to null, that means the user hasn't picked anything. So you just do datetime.now. But if the user has picked something, then it will not be null. So what you will do is actually use the my date time instead of datetime now. So if I just restart it now and I show you this again, you'll see that, let's go back to the past even. Let's go to, let's say, August 2020. the 4th of August. So once I tap it now, it's going to open on the 4th of August of 2020, which is exactly what we wanted. So there you have it. That's pretty much how it works. Hopefully this was able to help you. If it did, I just ask you to please leave me a like. It always helps with this channel. And of course, subscribe if you want to keep on learning more and more about Flutter. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.